Now let me talk about how we migrate from virtual cell to virtual port. In order to do that, let me start afresh with all these stations. Right? So let's start with a clean slate, as it were. So as I mentioned, in virtual port, what we are going to do is make sure that every device has its own personalized BSSID. So if you have two devices, each of them gets their own BSSID. So let's assume that there's station one that got BSSID 1. And there is station 2 that, based on this global topology, also got assigned to AP1. There's going to be BSSID 2, right? Now, as this station walks over, at some point, the infrastructure is going to decide, controller, centrally, based on this graph, that AP2 is better served to serve this client. So at that point, what happens is, as this station moves from here to here, we are going to take BSSID 1, we are going to marshal its state, and send it over to AP2. So notice that this personalized access point, virtual access point, or the BSSID, really moves along with the assignment of a station to the corresponding access point. And it has associated with it all the packets, all the sequence number, all the corresponding security state that was stored in this access point, and they get moved. So this is a key point. Now, you have a system wherein BSSIDs are associated with stations. And you have a protocol standard wherein all contention parameters are controlled per BSSID. So by migrating from a virtual cell where all devices connected to a single BSSID to one where they have their own unique BSSID, we got the added benefit that the infrastructure has the ability to distinguish the service between station 1 and station 2. If it turns out that station 1 is talking out of turn, it'll actually advertise the channel parameters to actually suppress its transmission. So the idea is that using this technology, migrating from virtual cell to virtual port, you can create the switch-like abstraction where each device effectively gets its own virtual port with per-device control or fine-grained control in terms of channel access as well as security parameters. Thank you.
A quick question.